what is there that Apple needs to be doing today to Siri, to its AI systems, to really catch up to what we've seen recently from Google and Amazon?
They've made some small changes that are impacting their AI, and one of them is really subtle but important, is that they, about a year ago, allowed their AI developers, their AI scientists, to publish some of their work. It's part of the community of being an AI scientist, is to be able to publish your work, and Apple and its secretive society historically hasn't let them do that, but they've opened up with that. And then recently they've hired the head of Google's AI. That's a big deal. It's a big deal because Google has said over the last 2 years in each of their earnings calls, they've always led with, we're an AI first company. So to poach the head of AI from Google, I think sends a message to the market that Apple wants to be serious about it. And they need to be serious about it because so far they really haven't, there's a lot of AI that's built into how your phone makes recommendations on text messages or organizes photos, things like that, how Siri works, but it still lags kind of where the other players are like Google. We measure smart speakers and the intelligence of smart speakers. And Google gets about, this is 800 queries we do twice a year. And Google gets about 84% of them right in our last one that we did. And then we did HomePod when it came out, and it was more like 57%. So it lagged. There's good news though for Apple, is that there are categories that right now Apple doesn't even participate in some of the Siri functionality. For example, navigation, this is with HomePod in particular, navigation or with commerce. If they would just turn those on, essentially, and we think we're gonna hear more about that at WWDC, about opening up Siri to new verticals. If they turn those on, you can see some quick gains against like Google when you compare these two.
Right, especially that's part of the success of Alexa. Maybe right out the gate it wasn't as capable, but the fact that Alexa was open to so many third parties, boom, overnight, it becomes much more capable than what
exactly
you see from Siri. Is it too late for Apple and the HomePod? If this smart speaker category really took off from Amazon, Google's eating into Amazon's market share a little bit. It seems like a two-man race right now. Is there room for a third player, and can Apple be that third player?
They can be a third player, a distant third player, though, in terms of market share.
Is it too late?
No, I think they're on track. I think they've got the right product, and I think that and they add these other functionality to it and adjust the price a little bit. I think that they can kind of get to that. And we think that third place kind of looks like 15 to 20% market share longer term. So right now there's sub 100 million smart speakers worldwide. And when you think about the smartphone, when you've got 3 billion more or less, there's a big opportunity for smartphones to grow. For the connected device, for a smart speaker to grow. And homes have multiple ones within it. Usually you have 1.25 phones, you might have several of these in your home. So I think that we got a long way to go in terms of market share gains. And so I think that Apple's still in a great place, but I think that their market share in HomePod is probably gonna gravitate to their similar market share they have with iPhone, which is kind of mid to high teen percent. And part of it is because they wanna make money on their hardware and they want a great hardware experience, and that shuts them out of a huge part of the market, that price point.
They announced the HomePod at WWDC. I would have thought that would have been a good excuse to say, hey, we're opening Siri up to, you know, this many more verticals or all verticals. Instead, we got a delayed HomePod and Siri is still functioning mostly the same.
Yeah, we were doubly disappointed, like you. We were expecting something when they announced HomePod. And then since HomePod was announced in the fall of last year, and then when they delayed it, we thought, well, then that's going to be in combination with an announcement that they're opening up Siri. So I guess maybe it might be three strikes and I'm out here if they don't deliver on opening up Siri.
Gene, thanks so much for joining us.
I had a ton of fun. Hope to see you soon.
Thanks.